Manalangin po tayo. Dakilang Panginoon Diyos, may-ari ng sanlibutan, pinupuri namin ang iyong pangalan. Kami nagpapasalamat sa panalangin at gabay na ibinigay mo sa amin. Salamat sa panibagong araw na ipinagkaloob mo. Salamat din sa pagkakataon na ibinigay mo upang kami ay muling magtipon para sa panibagong kaalaman. Kami po ay humihiling na nawa po ay gabayan mo po kami sa aming pag-aaral at bigyan mo po kami ng makalangit na kaalaman at lakas upang kami ay matuto. At nawa po ang lahat ng aming matutunan ay magamit namin sa pagtulong sa aming kapwa. Patawarin mo po kami sa aming mga kasalanan at nawa po ang lahat ng aming gagawin ay maging alinsunod sa iyong kautusan. Ang lahat ng ito ay aming sinasamo sa ngalan ng aming Panginoong Hesus. Amen. Magandang umaga po sa lahat ng mga kadete from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. Yung mga estudyante po natin sa Institutional Correction Subject, welcome! Welcome po, magandang umaga po sa inyo. This is the third, pangatlo po natin discussion sa subject na Institutional Correction Subject. Ilagay po natin ang discussions natin into 4 episodes para at least hindi po bitin, hindi po minabadali, at least comprehensive and exhaustive po yung discussions na ginagawa natin. Before anything else po, I'd like to congratulate yung top 10, yung latest top 10 po sa Criminologist Licensure Examination. Congratulations po! Such a wonderful achievement on your part po. Sa Pumasa na hindi included in the top 10, I tell you guys, napakagaling po ng Panginoon. Napakagaling po ng Panginoon. Let us praise the Lord na pumasa po kayo. Kasi po yung provisions natin sa Republic Act 11131, napakamadugo po. But at least, you were able to hurdle it po. You were able to hurdle it. Congratulations, my warmest felicitations po sa lahat ng pumasa sa latest Criminologist Licensure Examination. Sa mga kadete natin, yung mga kapatera natin na hindi pinalad, yung bumagsak po, this is my advice. Yung attitude po natin, criminology student tayo, di po ba? Ang attitude po natin, when we fall down, we get back up, we shake off the dust, we move on, and we move forward. Yun po ang attitude natin. Kasi kadete po tayo eh. Tatak criminology po tayo. Yung puso po natin is matibay. We are built to become mountains. And mountains do not bow down to little whispers of the wind. Nadapa tayo, we will strike again. May second chance pa po. This time, we do better. But in all things we do, cadet, dapat po, we will trust God's timing po. Let us be dependent with the guidance of God. So kung ano ba nang nangyari po, let us strike again, do our best, and who knows po, sa second take po natin, who knows, maging top-notcher po tayo or pumasa po tayo sa Criminologist Licensure Examination. Sa lahat ng pumasa, again, my warmest felicitations, may eligibility na po kayo. Kunting tiis na lang, maging police officer ka na, maging jail officer or fire officer, maging army or coast guard, depende po yan sa choice nyo po kasi may eligibility na po kayo. So, depende po sa inyo. But again, yung hindi po pumasa, do not be sad kasi po, matibay po ang puso natin, matibay po ang mindset po, being a criminology cadet. Alright? Now, I'd like to promote again yung Bicueno review materials po natin, yung book 1 and book 2. Yung book 1 po natin is a compilation of number 1, yung summarized review material sa lahat na po ng subjects sa 6 major areas. Lahat po, as in lahat. Okay? Lahat po ng subjects sa 6 major areas, may synthesized review materials na po yan. Plus, in book 1 also, yung last part niya po is question and answer portion po yan. Q&A. Yung Q&A po natin is a compilation of the questions taken from the previous Criminologist Licensure Examination. I tell you, You can actually use it, yung mga estudyante pa po natin, under the second year and third year, pati na yung fourth year level, wag lang po sa first year. Second year, third year, and fourth year levels po, you can order po para at least maging preparado po kayo, the soonest in taking the criminologist licensure examination. Yan po ang book 1 natin. Yung book 2 po natin is purely question and answer lang po yan. Okay? So pag nag-order na po kayo ng book 1, there's no need for you to order book 2. Kasi nga po, ang book 2 is question and answer lang po. And yung question and answer portion na yan is the same contents po na na-compile din po sa book 1. Okay po? So if you want to order, sa description po, sa video po na ito, you can see my name, you can message me through Facebook, and then we agree po kung saan po natin ipapadala yung purchase nyo po. Sa mga instructors natin yan, dyan, guest instructors, part-time instructors, yung mga guest lecturers natin in various review centers nationwide, moms and mga sirs, available po yung PowerPoint presentation po natin. Pag wala po tayong time, for example, institutional correction, wala tayong time kasi busy po tayo. Hindi tayo nakagawa ng PowerPoint presentation, wala tayong PDF. Just message me po kasi available din po yung PowerPoint presentation natin, pati na yung mga PDF files po sa lahat ng mga lectures natin na ginagawa sa channel po. Alright? Now, without so much delay po, because na-delay na po tayo ng several minutes, without so much delay, let us go now to the proper discussion. Unahin po natin yung structure, yung organizational structure po ng Bureau of Jail Management and Penology or yung tinatawag nating BJMP. Now, first thing is, yung BJMP was created under Republic Act 6975. Okay, the DILJ Act of 1990. 6975. Yan po ang batas na nag-create ng BJMP. Pero, wag din po natin kalimutan, sa nagre-review right now ha, dapat may ballpen kayo so that you can jot down notes. Wag po natin kalimutan that there were four agencies created under Republic Act 6975. Una, dyan po na-create yung tinatawag nating Philippine National Police or PNP. Pangalawa, yung Bureau of Jail Management and Penology or BJMP. Pangatlo, Bureau of Fire Protection. At saka yung pang-apat, yung Philippine Public Safety College. Yan po ang apat na mga ahinsa that were created by Republic Act 6975. So pag ang tanong po sa board examination ganito, which of the following laws created the BJMP, dapat ang answer is Republic Act 6975. If in the next question nakalagay, which of the following laws created the PNP, ang answer is the same, 6975. Kasi nga po, again, I repeat, apat po ang mga ahinsa na na-create ng Republic Act 6975, PNP, BJMP, BFP, and the Philippine Public Safety College. Now, question is, ano po ba ang hawak ng BJMP? Okay? Ano po ba ang hawak ng BJMP? Secondly, we have to put in mind na ang BJMP is under the Department of the Interior and Local Government. Under po siya sa DILJ. Okay? Ang BJMP po is under sa Department of the Interior and Local Government. Now, ang BJMP po, ang hawak niya po are the following. Number one, municipal jails. Number two, city jails. Okay? Municipal, city jails, pati na yung tinatawag nating district jails. Tatlo po ha. Municipal, city, and district jails. Hawak po yan ng BJMP. Question. Sir, provincial jail. Okay, ano po ba ang umbrella agency ng provincial jail? Ang provincial jail po is not directly under the supervision of the BJMP. But rather, yung provincial jail po is basically under the direct supervision of the provincial government. I repeat, yung provincial jail po is not directly under the supervision of the BJMP, but rather under the direct supervision of the provincial government. Buba sa episode 2, nakita po natin very fragmented po yung organizational structure na correction pillar. Kasi nga po, yung BJMP natin is under the DILJ, yung BUCOR is under the DOJ. Yung provincial jail is under the provincial government. May tinatawag pa nga tayong lock-up jail. Ang lock-up jail po is not under the BGMP, but rather it is under the Philippine National Police. Yung silda po, yung silda adjacent to the police station, is we call it as lock-up jail. That is under the supervision of the PNP, not the BGMP. So that's how fragmented po yung structure po natin. Now, tingnan po natin ang definition ng jail. Jail is a place for locking up of persons who are convicted, number one, of minor offenses or felonies, or number two, of offenses or felonies who are to serve a short sentence imposed upon them by a competent court, or number two, confinement of persons who are awaiting for trial or investigation of their cases. So, dalawa po ang purposes ng jail. Una po, it will in-house yung mga criminal convicted of minor offenses po. Convicted of minor offenses meaning it does not exceed 3 years. Pangalawa, confinement po siya, a detention facility for those persons awaiting for trial or those persons under investigation. Now, question. Sir, what if yung tao is convicted? Tapos yung penalty niya is, let us say, 3 years and 6 months. Again, in episode 1, I was very clear po, mga kadete, na pag nag-exceed po yung penalty niya sa 3 years, automatically, pag convicted po ang tao na yan, he has to be transported. It's either in the Bilibid prison or any penal institutions under the BUCOR or under the Bureau of Correction. So, hindi po siya ilagay sa BGMP, but rather pupunta po siya sa BUCOR kasi po nag-exceed na po sa 3 years yung penalty niya. Pero pag ang penalty niya is below 3 years or 3 years lang po and below, hindi po nag-exceed ha, 3 years lang po and below, that person shall be confined in the BJMP or the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology, particularly on the jail. Yan po ang pinagkaiba ng jail, BJMP, at saka yung sa BUCOR. Yung BJMP, under niya yung city jail, municipal jail, district jail. Yung BUCOR, under niya yung mga penal institutions or yung mga prisons. So pag again, 3 years po and below, yung conviction niya po, yung penalty niya, saan siya ilagay? BJMP. Pero pag umabot na po o ng 3 years and 1 day or above, ilagay po siya sa prison. Prison po or penal institution under sa BUCOR kasi po classified siya as a national prisoner. I hope you understand, cadets. I hope you really understand. Now to continue, tingnan po natin yung organization and key positions in the BJP, which is very similar sa Philippine National Police. Sa BJP po, ang pinakamataas na position dyan is yung chief BJP. Yung rangko niya po is jail director. May tatlo po na deputy chiefs that will assist him. Pareho sa PNP ha, pareho sa PNP. Second in command, yung deputy chief for administration. Third in command, deputy chief for operations. Fourth in command, yung chief of the directorial staff. Ang tatlo na deputy chief that will assist the chief BJMP shall have the rank of chief superintendent. Yung tatlo na yan, tatlo na assistants po, ang rangko po nila is chief superintendent. Ang rangko po ng chief BJMP is director. Now, ang tanong, ilang taon po ba? What is the tenure of office? Ilang years po ba mag-serve ang chief BJMP? Ang sagot po is 4. 4 years po, pero may exception po tayo. Just like in the PNP po, may exception. During the times of number one, national emergencies. Number two, war. Dalawa po ha, during war or national emergencies, the president can actually extend such tenure of office. So, pwede maging 5, pwede maging 6 years. Pag again, may war or pangalawa, may national emergencies. But in normal occasion po, during peacetime, during normal occasion, dapat po ang tenure of office niya should not exceed 4 years. Okay po? Now, yung latest law natin is yung Republic Act 9263, the Bureau of Fire Protection and Bureau of Jail Management and Penology Professionalization Act of 2004. So, yun po ang batas po na nag-professionalize sa BJMP along with the BFA. Take note po ha, Republic Act 9263. Okay? So, yun po ang structure sa national office po. Punta tayo sa regional office, patungong municipal office. Sa regional offices naman ng BJMP, ang pinakamataas is yung tinatawag nating regional director. Ang rangko niya po is at least senior superintendent. Senior superintendent. So balikan natin para at least maintindihan talaga. Balikan po natin. Pinakamataas, Chief BJMP. Sunod sa Chief BJMP, Deputy Chief for Administration. Sunod sa Deputy Chief for Administration is Deputy Chief for Operation. Number 4, yung Chief of Directorial Staff. Sunod dyan is yung Regional Office or yung Regional Director. Rangko niya po is Senior Superintendent. The same manner, the same setup po yung Regional Office with the National Office. Ang Regional Director or yung RD is also assisted by the 3 assistants. Number 1, yung Assistant Regional Director for Administration. Pangalawa, Assistant Regional Director for Operations. Pangatlo, Regional Chief of Directorial Staff. Ang rangko po sa mga tatlong assistants ng Regional Director, ang rangko po niya is Superintendent. I hope you understand po, cadets. Now, from the regional level, tingnan naman natin ang sa provincial level, yung provincial level po. Sa provincial level, may tinatawag tayo, ang pinakamataas na position dyan is Provincial Jail Administrator. Ang rangko niya po is at least, same po sa mga assistant sa RD, rangko niya po is Jail Superintendent. Next sa provincial level is yung district office, headed by a district warden. Yung rangko niya po is at least Jail Superintendent. Tapos ng district office, yung yung nasa baba is yung city office. City warden po yung pinakamataas na position. Yung rangko niya po is jail chief inspector. Tapos yung sa municipal jail, sa municipal office, yung head po is yung warden pa din. Yung rank niya po should be at least jail inspector. So yun po, kindly familiarize po mga kadet, especially yung nagre-review right now. Familiarize po sa structure natin ha, sa structure natin sa Bureau of Jail Management and Penology. Now, if ang tao po mag-apply sa BJMP po, yung pumasa sa Criminologist Licensure Examination, gusto maging jail officer, sino po ba ang mag-appoint sa kanya being jail officer 1? Take a look po sa appointment of uniform personnel to the BFP and BJMP. Pag jail officer 1 po yan, patungong jail officer 4, ang mag-appoint po is yung regional director. Klaro po yan ha? Regional director pag regional uniform personnel po. Pero pag ang tao is national uniform personnel po, doon po sa national headquarter po, ang mag-appoint is the chief BJMP. But in most cases, let us say for example, I am from Negros Oriental, tapos nag-apply ako sa regional office ng BJMP. Ang mag-appoint po sa akin, kasi nag-apply ako sa region, ang mag-appoint po sa akin is no less than the regional director. Okay? Pero pag andun po sa national headquarter, ang mag-appoint po is yung chief BJMP. The same setup po ha, the same setup po sa Bureau of Fire Protection. For example, sa BFP din po, ang chief BFP, siya din po ang mag-appoint sa fire officer 1 to senior fire officer 4. Sir, bakit pati yung jail officer 2 up to jail officer 4 is within the jurisdiction po ng regional director. Kasi nga po, if you are already hired as a jail officer 1 and then you want to be promoted to jail officer 2, tapos may enough qualifications ka to be promoted to the next level, ang mag-appoint again is no less than the regional director for regional uniform personnel, but for national uniform personnel is yung chief BJMP. So meaning, promotion mo from jail officer 1 up to jail officer 2 up to jail officer 4, ang mag-appoint po dyan is yung regional director again for regional uniform personnel. And pag sa headquarter naman, national headquarter is yung chief BGMP. Of course, with the attestation of the Civil Service Commission. Now, punta tayo sa the next rank. After is JO4, after Senior Jail Officer 4, would be Jail Inspector. Now, from Jail Inspector up to Jail Superintendent, ang mag-appoint po, okay, ang mag-promote, ang mag-appoint, should be the respective chief of, sa fire po, would be the chief of the BFP. Pag sa BGMP naman, ang mag-appoint sa Jail Inspector up to Jail Superintendent would be the Chief BGMP. Of course, with recommendations from immediate supervisors or superiors and with the attestation coming from the Civil Service Commission. Sunod, after Jail Superintendent would be Jail Senior Superintendent. Sa fire would be Fire Senior Superintendent. Sino po ba ang mag-appoint? Ang mag-appoint is no less than the Secretary of the Department of the Interior and Local Government, DILG po ha, na Secretary, with the recommendations coming from the Chief BGMP, okay, and proper attestation with the Civil Service Commission. On the other hand, ang taas po sa Senior Superintendent would be Jail Chief Superintendent up to Jail Director. Ang mag-appointa po dyan is the President himself. The President, of course, with the recommendations of the Secretary of the DILG and with proper endorsement by the Chairman of the Civil Service Commission. Yun po ang system natin sa pag-appoint ng mga rangko sa Bureau of Jail Management and Penology. Now, balikan po natin ang mga ranks, okay? Balikan po natin. Ang PNP po may military ranks po. We transition from the old ranks, yung PO1, PO2 into the militaristic rank, yung military rank. Pero yung BGMP at BFP retain po yung system natin ng ranking po. Sa non-commissioned officers, okay? Isinali ko na po yung sa fire. Makikita nyo po sa slide, tingnan nyo po. Jail Officer 1, Jail Officer 2, Jail Officer 3, then Senior Jail Officer 1, 2, 3, and 4. Ito po ang mga non-commissioned officers. Punta tayo sa commissioned officers. Sunod sa SGO4, huwag kalimutan, would be Inspector, Senior Inspector, Chief Inspector, Chief Superintendent, up to the Jail Director. Tingnan nyo po ang kanilang comparable ranks po sa military. Of course, pag inspector po dyan, it's lieutenant. Okay? Yung police inspector noon, naging police lieutenant na ngayon. Remember na yung jail director po natin is two-star general po yan. Two-star general, huwag kalimutan ha, two-star general, yung chief superintendent natin is one-star general. One-star general for chief superintendent. Yung director natin is two-star general. Question, sino po ba yung may rangko na chief superintendent? Yun po ang mga three assistants. Yung deputy chief for administration, deputy chief for operations, pati na yung chief of directorial staff. Yun po, mga chief superintendent po yun. So I hope you understand ha, cadets. I hope you understand. Next, let us go now to the duties and responsibilities. Ano po ba ang mga responsibilidad ng mga positions sa BGMP? Let us go first sa warden. Okay? Yung warden po sa municipal city at sa district na jails. Warden. Ano po ba ang responsibility niyan? Number one, direction, coordination, and control of the jail. Number two, responsible sa security, safety, discipline, and well-being of the inmates. For short, yung management mismo ng jail, responsibilidad po yan ng warden. Ang assistant warden naman, on the other hand, is the office of the assistant warden undertakes the development of a systematic process of treatment, meaning yung rehabilitation po, ha, yung IWDP na tinatawag natin, Inmates Welfare and Development Program, ang focal person po sa pag-implement niyan, ang pag-implement dyan would be the assistant warden. Also, take note po, mga kadete na nagre-review right now, ang assistant warden po is the chairman of the classification board at the same time, the chairman of the disciplinary board. Ano po ba yung classification board? Ang classification is basically yung segregating inmates or prisoners according to various circumstances. Segregating, separating them into gender or sex, separating them in accordance to the level of security, separating them according to age. Yun po, classification po yan. Ang disciplinary board naman is basically a body, a board that will hear any complaints related po sa jail. Okay? For example, somebody is doing malingering inside the jail, or somebody is not performing his task. Saan po ilalagay dyan? Saan po ang hearing? Sa disciplinary board. Sino po ang chairman ng classification and disciplinary boards? Ang chairman po is yung assistant warden. Hindi yung warden, ha? Sa board examination, lalabas to. Lalabas, I tell you. Ang assistant warden po ang chairman ng classification and of course, the disciplinary board. Now, aside from the warden and the assistant warden, another key position is yung administrative group. From the word admin. So, lahat ng mga administrative functions of the jail bureau, yung records, yung mga files, is basically under the administrative groups. Aside from the administrative groups, yung security groups, ito po ang position responsible po sa custody, security, control ng inmates, pati na yung movements. At the same time, ang security groups is also in charge with jail discipline. Disiplina po ng mga inmates. Saan po? Security groups. Pag may infraction, may na-commit na violation yung inmate, saan po ba ang hearing? Disciplinary board. Sino po ang chairman ng disciplinary board? Assistant warden. But sino po ba ang mag-instill ng discipline within the prison? It's no other than the security groups. Now, ang security groups are actually comprised into two subgroups. Una, yung escort platoon. Pangalawa, yung security platoon. Under the escort platoon, itong tinatawag nating escort section. Ano bang escort section? To escort inmate upon order of any judicial body, upon summon of a court or transfer to other penal institutions. Ano po ba ang purpose ng escort section? Pag may order po ang court, sabihin, may summon ha, sabihin ng korte, hoy, si Juan de la Cruz will have to be brought to the regional trial court kasi may hearing on this particular day and particular date or time. So sino po ba ang mag-escort, ang magdala ng inmate na being summoned to the RTC? Sino ang magdala? Ang escort section. Pag may order po. But take note po mga kadete, ang movement po sa lahat ng mga inmates and prisoners outside the institution shall only be done within the order of the competent court. Mangyari lang po ang movement ng prisoners outside the institution pag may order po ng korte. Pag may order po ng korte. So meaning, pag walang order, ibig sabihin dyan, hindi mo pwedeng palabasin yung inmate. Dalhin mo sa oval para mag-jogging. No, that is not highly recommended. Why? Kasi nga po, yung movement outside the institution, magawa lang po yan pag may order po ng korte. Sino ang mag-escort? Escort section. Pangalawa, supina section. Siya po ang mag-receive, mag-distribute ng court summons, notices, subpoenas, etc. Pag may mga orders po, ang receiving section po, ay yung subpoena section po ang mag-manage dyan. Pangalawang subgroup is yung security platoon. A 3 working platoon shifts responsible for overall security of the jail compound, including gates, guards, posts and towers. They are also responsible for the admitting and releasing unit. Admitting, ibig sabihin ng admitting, yung pag-receive, pati na yung pag-release. Sino po ba? May responsibility din po ang security platoon. Ang security platoon din po ang mag-maintain ng safety and security within the parameters, within the perimeters rather, of the jail institution. So siya po ang mag-guard sa gate, siya po ang may shift po, yung sabihin natin yung graveyard shift, siya po ang magbantay. For sure, taga-bantay po yung security platoon. Other key position is the rehabilitation purposes groups. Okay, rehabilitation purposes groups. This group provides services and assistance to prisoners and their families to enable them to solve their individual needs and problems arising from the prisoner's confinement. Ano po ba ang job ng rehabilitation purposes groups? Siya po ang magbigay ng aid or assistance. Saan ibibigay yung aid and assistance? Sa mga prisoners, pati na yung mga pamilya nila. Para at least yung mga problema ng mga families o problema ng prisoners can be solved or can be given just solutions. Una, under rehabilitation purposes group, yung tinatawag nating medical, health, services, libre po to ha. Mga kadete, libre po ito lahat. Yung medical and health services branch, problema sa medical, physical examination, pati na yung treatment of sick inmates, libre po yan, pati yung recommendation for hospitalization. It also conducts psychiatric and psychological examination. Napakaganda po pakinggan. Napakagandang pakinggan po. I hope in reality, this is practiced. I was in the one of the district jails in Negros Oriental to conduct research. I think I was there for about 3 days, 3 or 4 days. I tell you, medical and health services branch, meron po. But then again, the question is it, are the services offered or are this kind of services offer a holistic approach in the treatment of the inmates? So problema, may mga problema po sa mga jails po natin. Although may treatment, pero yung treatment na binigay is yung limited only on high blood or hypertension. So yung tinatawag na psychiatric and psychological examinations, this is rarely done. This is rarely done, I tell you. So, I hope there will be changes. Yung jail overcrowding natin, jail overcrowding which is also one of the most prevalent challenges faced right now by the BGMP. Ito po, yung jail overcrowding that results to a lot of physical illnesses inside the jail. And I tell you, napakaganda pong tingnan yung medical and health services branch. Pero yung implementation po natin, sometimes po, I'm very sorry, BGMP, sometimes po, yung implementation natin sa medical and health services is not holistic. Okay? Yung gamot po natin, medyo limited lang po tayo for hypertension, toothache, stomach ache, fever. Di ba? So, minsan kulang pa. Alright, so yun po, medical and health services branch po, part ng rehabilitation purposes groups. Another is yung work and education therapy services. Okay, work and education. So from the words, work and education, so ibig sabihin, livelihood programs, yung job and educational programs needed for the rehabilitation of inmates. Pag ang inmate po na-confine sa isang jail institution and he was just a graduate of grade 1 section 31. Hindi nakatapos ng grade 2. Ay, may ALS po, alternative learning system ng Department of Education that can coordinate or collaborate with the jail management. So yung ALS po, iimbitahin po 'yan ng jail ng work and education therapy services then to give free education. So, paglabas ng isang tao from the jail institution, nako, naging graduate na ng elementary. Naging graduate na ng high school. May TESDA diploma na. Okay, marunong ng mag-welding. Kung yung tao, basagulero sa labas, pagdating sa loob, nako, naging responsable na. He knows about the making handicrafts or making lanterns or maybe whatever kind of stuff na ginagawa po nila as livelihood program po. So, responsibility po yan ng work and education therapy services. Pangatlo is yung socio-cultural services. Lahat ng social casework study of the individual prisoners by making interviews, home visits, referral to community resources, free legal services, and liaison works for the inmates. Naku, napakaganda po, tingnan. Socio-cultural services that will actually take a look kung ano po ba ang kailanganin ng isang inmate, ng isang prisoner. If he needs a resources, probably work, pati na yung legal services, ito po ang socio-cultural services po ang may responsibility diyan. So yan po ang isa sa mga branches ng rehabilitation purposes groups. Pang-apat, yung chaplaincy services. So from the word chaplaincy, yung religious aspect ng tao, yung religious aspect ng prisoner can be restored or can be amplified by means of these services. Basically, we call this in the other terms as religious services. Okay? So, I tell you, when I visited one of the district jails in Negros Oriental, I tell you, cadets, this is based on real life experience. Ang sabi po ng isang inmate, he was very blessed and happy to be confined in a district jail. Bakit po? Because the district jail was actually the place where he knows about God. And I tell you, during the interview, he was bringing with him a Bible. And he was very happy about it. He was okay that he was confined. And he was saying that it would be okay for him to be confined there for a lifetime. Just because of, you know, religious services. But this religious service is very good because, number one, it actually buffers yung boredom ng jail. Number two, it does not only buffer, it also uplifts the morality, the spiritual aspect of the person. When the spiritual aspect po ng tao is lifted, I tell you, yung religious aspect has a bigger role actually in providing rehabilitation of a person, changing him from a law violator into a law-abiding citizen of the country. Ang religious aspect has a primordial role. It has a primordial role in terms of rehabilitating the person from law violator into a law-abiding citizen of the country. Okay, so lahat ng religious aspects, chaplaincy services po yan. On the other hand, libre din po to. Libre din po, guidance and counseling services. So, responsible for the individual and group counseling activities to help inmates solve their individual problems and to help them lead a wholesome and constructive life. So, basically, ang guidance and counseling is a type of services that is given to inmates, giving them good advices, good suggestions para at least makatulong sa kanilang mga individual na problema. So, yun po ang mga key positions po natin, ha. Yun po ang mga key positions po natin in the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology. Now, as to the jail manning level, mga kadete po na nagre-review right now, especially yung nag-self-review, kasi medyo kapos po tayo ng pera. Okay lang po yan. Kahit ta self-review lang, you just take a look on the video discussions that we are having right now. Marami po ang lalabas dito. And actually, you can utilize this as a weapon in taking the CLE. Jail manning level, huwag kalimutan, cadets. Jail manning level, custodial ratio, ha, sa jail, 1 personnel for every 7 inmates. 1:7. 1:7 custodial ratio po yan. So, ibig sabihin, pag isa kang jail officer, while you are making your tour of duty, ang ratio po dapat is sa 7 inmates, yan po, in charge mo po yan to oversee that 7 inmates. 1:7. Sa courtroom ratio naman, ibig sabihin, dinala yung inmate or prisoner for appearance inside the court. Ang courtroom ratio po natin, 2 personnel po sa isang inmate. Isa ka prisoner, dalawang personnel, dalawang jail personnel, 2:1. Balik tayo, custodial ratio, 1:7. Meaning, pag ang inmates po, nasa custodia, nasa jail institution, one jail personnel, hawak niya po ang 7 inmates. Pero pag nasa korte po yung inmate, dapat po 2 jail personnel, isang inmate. So meaning, pag 2 inmates yung dinala doon, dapat po may 4 na jail personnel na nakabantay. On the regular escort ratio, 1 personnel for every 1 inmate plus 1 personnel for high-risk inmate. So 1:1 pag yung inmate po is not does not require much security. Pero pag high-risk inmate po, naging +1. So, ibig sabihin, pag isang high-risk inmate, dapat 2 po sa regular escort ratio. Pero pag hindi lang po siya high-risk na inmate, 1:1 lang po yung ratio po natin. Okay? I hope may nakukuha po, kadete ha. I hope may nakukuha po. Now, listen up po. Punta tayo sa prison. Punta tayo sa prison. Mayroon tayong tinatawag na RDC o the Reception and Diagnostic Center. Okay? Ang RDC is located in the Camp Sampaguita. Diba? Camp Sampaguita, Camp Liwayway. Diba? In the second episode, sabi ko, mnemonics natin is Limin and Sammed. Limin means bukang Liwayway. Liwayway meaning minimum security yung mga prisoners dyan. Sammed, Sampaguita, Camp Sampaguita, yung mga prisoners dyan is medium security prisoners. Okay? So, ang RDC po is located in the Camp Sampaguita. So, ang RDC, ang responsibility niya po is to undergo or is to conduct diagnostic examination, study and observation for the purposes of determining the programs of treatment and training best suited to their needs and the institution to which they should be transferred. So basically, ang purpose po ng RDC is titingnan po nila kung ano po ba ang specific na mga programa na pwedeng masuit sa isang particular prisoner. Okay? Iba-iba din po ang mga needs ng mga prisoners. So ang responsibility ng RDC is to find out kung ano po ba ang needs per inmate by conducting, of course, a diagnostic examination. Now, ang RDC composed of the following staff. Number one, psychiatrist responsible in the examination sa mental and emotional makeup. Tingnan po kung suicidal ba or hindi. Kung depressed ba or hindi. Problemado ba or normal. Pangalawa, psychologist responsible to conduct study on the character and behavior of the prisoner. Psychiatrist is on the emotional and the mind. Psychologist is on the character and behavior of the prisoner. Number three, yung sociologist. Study the social case situation of the individual prisoner. Ano ba yung social case? Ibig sabihin, kung ano ba yung surrounding circumstances ng isang prisoner. For example, pag isang prisoner, saan po siya tumira? If he is residing on a place surrounded by gamblers and alcoholics and drug addicts, of course, you have to expect na yung prisoner will also develop the same characteristic. So, ang pag-determine po, pag-study po sa mga social circumstances ng isang tao is within the responsibility of the sociologist. We also have the educational counselor. Yung educational counselor will change inmates' attitudes towards education and recommends educational program for the prisoner. So, pag hindi po siya nakagraduate ng elementary, so he will recommend to take the alternative learning system. Pag wala po siyang livelihood program, hindi marunong mag-welding, hindi marunong magtrabaho, so the educational counselor, siya po will recommend on a specific livelihood program or educational program na pwedeng maibigay sa isang prisoner. Next, the vocational counselor. So aside from the educational counselor, may vocational counselor pa din, which is specific po siya sa vocational course. Pero puro pareho lang po yan. Ang educational counselor is to recommend what specific education. Kasali na din po yan yung sa TISDA, yung sa NCTO. Pero yung specific na tao who will man or who will supervise sa implementation ng vocational program would be the vocational counselor. Ano po ba yung mga skills na pwedeng maibigay sa isang prisoner? Sunod, part of the RDC itong chaplain. Sa BJMP, pareho lang din po yung role niya. Ang chaplaincy is on participation of the prisoner on the religious activities para at least ma-amplify yung religious aspect niya. Diba? Yung religious aspect niya. Sunod, yung medical officer that will conduct physical examination and recommends medical treatment of prisoners. Pag may high blood ka, pag diabetic yung tao, pag may sakit sa puso, pag may sakit sa kidney, ito po ang may responsibility dyan is medical officer. Pero again po, do not assume po that yung medicine po natin is complete, yung gamot po natin is complete in jails or prisons. Do not expect po ha. Again, these are sweet as honey type of concepts. But in terms of the implementation, medyo may problema po tayo. Okay? Next, aside from the medical officer, we also have the custodial correctional officer. Ang custodial correctional officer recommends the transfer and type of custody of inmates. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng type of custody? Titingnan din po kung saang level siya ng security. Can he be classified as a minimum risk prisoner, medium risk prisoner, maximum, yung mga ganyan. And yun po ang part ng RDC. Another would be the quarantine cell or unit. Okay, ang quarantine cell or unit. This is a unit of the prison or a section of the RDC where the prisoner is given thorough physical examination including blood test, x-rays, vaccinations, and immunity. This is for the purpose of ensuring that the prisoner is not suffering from any contagious disease which might be transferred to the prison population. Saan po siya ilalagay? Sa quarantine cell or unit. For example, during pandemic, saan po ilagay yung nag-positive ng COVID? Sa quarantine cell or unit. May tuberculosis or may TB po yung tao which can be contagious. So saan po siya ilalagay? Ilagay po siya sa quarantine cell or unit. Diyan din po an examination, medical examination such as blood test, x-rays, and vaccinations and immunity are being conducted. Okay po? Now, sa pagpapatuloy po, titingnan po natin kung ano po ba yung systematic process sa reception, not just only within the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology, but we will also try to take a look kung ano po ba yung mga procedures that should be followed in receiving a particular inmate or prisoner. Pati na sa prison na, titingnan po natin ang proseso sa BJMP and then secondly, yung proseso sa prison. Unahin po natin, cadets, itong BJMP reception procedures. Kung ano po ba ang proseso sa pag-receive ng inmate sa BJMP. Pag ang tao, for example, let us say, a police officer bringing with him a person to be confined. Ang first contact po is yung gaiter. Okay? First contact ka, huwag niyong kalimutan ha. First contact, gaiter. Yung na-assign sa gate, he or she checks the credentials of the person bringing the inmate, the committing officer, to determine his or her identity and authority. So, ang responsibility ng gaiter, una, i-check niya po yung credentials or yung authority sa tao na nagdala ng inmate or prisoner. Ano po ba ang authority niya? Pag may authority, ang gaiter will also reviews the completeness of the following documents before the person bringing an inmate or the committing officer is allowed to enter the facility. Gaiter ha, nasa gate po yan. Titingnan niya kung ano po ba ang authority pag si Juan de la Cruz nagdala ni Pedro para i-confine si Pedro. So sasabihin ng gaiter, ano po ba ang authority mo? Patingin po ng credentials. Tapos, after that, i-check niya yung mga following documents. Following documents, una, yung tinatawag nating commitment order. Ano ba itong commitment order? This is basically an order signed by the judge that will actually order The jail officer to confine the person stated in that order to put him into detention or to put him into jail. A written order of the court or any agency authorized by law to issue entrusting an inmate to a jail for a purpose of safekeeping during the pendency of his or her case. So basically, your commitment order is just an order coming from the judge directed to a jail officer. Sabihin ng judge, hoy, Mr. Jail Officer, you put this person into jail or you put this person into prison. Commitment order. Sino ang nag-issue? Yung judge. Sino yung binigyan ng order? Yung jail officer. Pangalawa, yung medical certificate. Check din po yan ng Gator. Recent medical certificate taken, huwag kalimutan, within 24 hours prior to admission. Sino po ba ang nag-issue ng medical certificate? Usually po sa normal setup natin, ito po yung physician coming from the provincial hospital, yung public hospital po. Pangatlo na i-check yung complaint and information. Ano pong pinagkaiba sa dalawa aside from the spelling? Yung complaint is a written accusation furnished by the complainant. Yung information is a written accusation furnished by the prosecutor or the fiscal. So part din po na i-check ng Gator. Pangapat, police booking sheet. So sa police booking sheet, ang may responsibility po niyan is yung PNP. Ang PNP po ang mag-issue. Panglima, yung certificate of detention from PNP and or NBI. Certificate of detention from PNP again and or NBI, pag na-detain po yung tao in a lock-up jail sa PNP or within the custody of the National Bureau of Investigation. Now, pag kumpleto po, let's just say, hindi kumpleto, walang commitment order, anong gagawin ng Gator? Pag hindi kumpleto, he should not be allowed to gain access on the facility. Kasi nga po, walang commitment order. Pero pag kumpleto, ilagay na lang natin sa situation na kumpleto po yung documents niya. So, pag kumpleto, ang second contact would be the records unit. So, yung records unit will examine again the completeness and not only the completeness of the documents but also the authenticity. Anong ibig sabihin ng authenticity? Ibig sabihin ang originality, genuine ba yung mga documents? Yung commitment order, yung arrest report, yung information, yung complaint, lahat-lahat na before it refers the inmate for physical examination by the health unit. Titingnan po kung authentic ba, original ba, or genuine po yung mga forwarded documents. Pero na-check na po yan sa Gator, ha? Unang chinek ng Gator, kompleto. Second contact, records unit, i-check ang originality ng document. Pag original, okay, genuine, authentic, forward niya yung inmate sa health unit para mag-check naman ng physical aspect ng tao. So yung health unit will conduct, again, physical examination of the inmate para at least malaman kung ano po ba yung current physical condition niya. Now, after the health unit, balik uli sa records unit. So, receives the inmate and the documents from committing officer and conducts the following. Start the booking procedures, accomplish the jail booking sheet, strip search the inmate to check for any birthmarks, tattoos, or etc. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng strip search? Ibig sabihin ng strip search, nakahubad ka po. Wala pong suot yan. Strip search. Okay? Strip search po ang tawag. Ibig sabihin, nakahubad po. Encode the inmate's information, fingerprint, and photograph the inmate with a mugshot background. List the names of the visitors authorized by the inmates. Kung sino po ba yung pwede makabisita sa kanya. Secondly, apprise the inmate in a dialect that he or she understands of the provisions of Article 29 of the RPC which was further amended by Republic Act 10592. Ano ba itong Republic Act 10592? Good conduct time allowance. Okay, na-discuss po natin to, ha, in the second episode. Good conduct time allowance. For example, 1 to 2 years of good behavior. Ilang days po ba ang deduction niya per month pag nagbehave siya, 1 to 2 years? Answer po dyan is 20 days. Pakitingin po sa episode 2, ha. Number 3, facilitate the signing of the detainee's manifestation. pag nag-agree po siya to abide on the disciplinary rules. Pag ayaw niya po mag-agree, ayaw niyang mag-sign sa detainee's manifestation, ang ibibigay po is a certification under oath manifesting that the inmate was apprised of the provisions of Article 29 of the RPC as amended and refused to abide by the same. Pag ayaw niya po. Pero pag magpirma po siya, bigay yung detainee's manifestation. Next would be to store all documents in the inmate's karpeta. Question. Sir, ano ba itong karpeta? Okay? Actually, this is a very easy, term. Parang pansit na po sa mga sa nagre-review right now, you know already what is karpeta. Pero sa mga estudyante po natin under the institutional correction subject, pag karpeta po ang na-mention ng instructor, ibig sabihin diyan inmate record. Simply inmate record or other term is jacket. Inmate record. So yung inmate record natin, it will consist all records relative to the inmates, documents related to his or her incarceration. For example, ang commitment order niya, ang supena niya, yung personal identification niya, orders coming from the court, and all papers related to his detention or confinement, ilagay po yan sa isang folder. Ang isang folder po na yan is his prison record, his inmate record or jacket, or otherwise known as karpeta. Yan po ang karpeta. Sir, ano po bang pinagkaiba ng karpeta at saka yung prison record? Yung karpeta is basically consisting all papers or documents related to the confinement or detention of the prisoner. Pero yung prison record lang po is only limited to the inmate's personal circumstances, pati yung yung offense or crime that he committed, ilang taon yung sentensya niya, yung criminal case niya sa trial, ano yung place of confinement, ano yung date of expiration of sentence. Yun po, prison record po yan. Okay? Limited po yan sa kanyang personal circumstances, yung offense na commit niya, yung sentence imposed, yung criminal case niya, yung place of confinement, tsaka yung expiration of sentence. Ano po bang tawag? Prison record. Pero yung karpeta, an inmate record or jacket is basically consists of a compilation of papers related to the inmate. Pati na yung supena, commitment order, personal identification, so on and so forth. Yan po ang pinagkaiba sa dalawa. Next, after the records unit, the next contact would be the property custodian. Okay? Ano po ba ang responsibility ng property custodian? To check the belongings of the inmate, titingnan kung may presensya ba ng contraband. Ano ba yung ibig sabihin ng contraband? Anything, any material, any tool or any equipment, any device that is in violation to the prison or jail rules. Anything that is not allowed, contraband. Kukuhain po yung cash and other personal properties from the inmate, list them down on a receipt form with duplicate, duly signed by him or her and countersigned by the inmate. The original receipt, dalawa pong copies yan ha, yung resibo po. Original receipt shall be given to the inmate, duplicate receipt shall be given to the property custodian. So paglabas ng prisoner, paglabas ng inmate, kasi tapos na po yung sentensya niya, ha, kukuhain or he will get the equipment listed in that property receipt. Pag nakalagay dyan, naibigay mo sa property custodian 20 million pesos, so dapat paglabas mo, may 20 million pesos ka dapat na isauli. Next, desk officer. After the property custodian, pupunta siya sa desk officer, books the newly committed inmate in the jail blotter, assigns the inmate to a reception area, if any, where he or she shall be scheduled for orientation on jail rules and regulation and shall undergo risk assessment and classification, evaluation, and conduct of further medical evaluation screening by the medical officer. So, yun po ang next contact. Now, after the desk officer, the next contact would be an assistant warden or officer of the day. Pag wala po yung assistant warden, ang officer of the day po yung next contact. So siya po ang mag-orient sa newly committed inmate sa lahat ng regulations, sa lahat ng rules, inside prison using the inmate's orientation sheet. So yan po ang purpose ng assistant warden or officer of the day. Sunod, pagtapos na po yung assistant warden, the next contact would be the jail warden. Ito na po ang pinakalast. Ang jail warden will not actually brief the inmate upon arrival. Pero ang responsibility ng warden is basically on coordination sa lahat ng concerned agencies regarding the case of inmate para at least mas madali yung disposition and to furnish them with copies of the available needed documents. So, the responsibility of the jail warden is to see to it that all concerned agencies and persons will be informed of the commitment of the inmate in his or her jail by submitting a written report. So, for example, dapat nakasubmit siya ng report sa jail. Okay, nakasubmit siya ng report sa jail that he already received the inmate. But then again, the jail warden will not orient. The orientation shall only be done by the assistant warden or the officer of the day. Ang sa jail warden only is on the coordination sa lahat ng concerned agencies, informing them, providing them a copy about this inmate, okay, that he has been confined in this particular facility. So yun po ang BJMP reception procedures. Can you take it down po, mga kadete, ha? Review the discussion as much as possible para at least you can actually understand po sa mga procedure. Kasi po, sa latest table of specification, isa din po ito sa mga highlights. Okay? Sunod, tapos na po tayo sa BJMP, alright? Tapos na tayo sa BJMP reception procedures. Tingnan natin ang admission naman procedures ng prison. Sa prison naman tayo. Okay? Kung ano po ba ang systematic procedures na na-utilize sa kanilang institution. Una, receiving. Okay? Sa prison tayo, ha? Prison under the Bureau of Correction or BUCOR. Wala na po tayo sa BJMP. Una is itong receiving. So, receiving, the new prisoner is received saan? The RDC. Ano po ba yung RDC kanina? The Reception and Diagnostic Center. So, the new prisoner usually comes from a provincial or city jail where he was immediately committed upon conviction by the court and escorted by the escort platoon during his transfer to the national prison. So, again, pag ang tao is convicted, pero yung conviction niya does not exceed 3 years, does not exceed, saan siya ilalagay? Sa BJMP. Sa city jail, municipal jail, or district jail, or sa provincial jail. A provincial jail is under sa provincial government. Doon siya ilagay. Pag hindi nag-exceed ng 3 years. Pero pag nag-exceed ng 3 years yung conviction niya, ang gagawin is that he will be transported to the prison, penal institution na under sa BUCOR. So, sino po ba ang mag-receive? Yung RDC. Ano po ba yung mga key positions sa RDC? Yung na-mention natin kanina, andon po ang educational counselor, andon po ang chaplaincy, andon po ang psychiatrist, andon po ang psychologist. Okay? So, una, receiving, saan? The RDC. Sunod, checking of commitment papers. The receiving officer checks the commitment papers if they are in order. That is, if they contain the signature of the judge or the signature of the clerk of court and the seal of the court. Requirements. Number one, commitment order or mitimos. Pareho lang po yan, ha? Again, ano ba itong commitment order or mitimos? Pareho lang din po sa commitment order sa jail. This is an order na na-sign ng judge, of course, bearing the seal by the judge, directed to a jail officer commanding him to receive the person indicated in that order for custody or for the service of sentence imposed therein. So, ang sabi po, dokumento po yan, na nasign ng huwis or ng judge ordering this jail officer to receive this person for custody or for the service of sentence. Ano po ang tawag? Commitment order or mitimos. Aside from the commitment order or mitimos, titingnan din po ang medical certificate niya, yung complaint and information, police booking sheet. Titingnan din po, pare-pareho lang po ang procedure sa prison with the BJMP. Sunod, identification. The prisoner's identity is established through, again, fingerprinting, meaning he will be fingerprinted. Yung fingerprint, rolled fingerprint niya shall be taken. The mugshots shall also be taken. And then, this is to ensure that the person being committed is the same as the person being named in the commitment order. So yung tao, the prisoner's identity is established through the picture and fingerprint appearing in the commitment order. So kukuhaan po ng picture at saka yung fingerprint. Sunod, searching. So, ang nakalagay dito is this step involves the frisking of the prisoner and searching his personal things. Ano po ba ang pinagkaiba ng frisk search at saka yung strip search? Ang strip search, meaning nakahubad ka. Ang frisk search, ibig sabihin, may suot ka lang po. Ha? You have clothing, upper garments and the lower garments. And then the officer will tap for any contrabands. Not necessarily strip. All the officer has to do is to tap your body pag may contraband po ba. Weapons and other items classified as contraband are confiscated and deposited to the property custodian. This is also referred to as shakedown. Okay. Ano bang ibig sabihin nito? Shakedown. Shakedown. Marami po ito po ha mga kadete ha. Let me be very honest po with my emotions right now. Mayroon po kasing isang review material po. Ha? Sorry to mention na. May isa pong review material dyan na nagsasabi na ang shakedown po is the process of taking photographs and fingerprint of the prisoner. Maling-mali po. Ha? Ang shakedown is not about fingerprinting and taking picture. Ibig sabihin po ng shakedown, I hope that review center is listening right now. Ibig sabihin po ng shakedown, meaning nag-search ka for contraband. Ha? Nag-search ka for contraband. Ibig sabihin shakedown. When the prisoner arrives at the prison institution, the prison officers will have to conduct shakedown. Ibig sabihin ng shakedown, i-search po pag may contraband po ba yung tao. Okay? Take note po ha, kadete, pakitingin po sa mga other review materials that you are having right now. Pag nakalagay po dyan, shakedown, fingerprinting, and picture taking, nako! Kindly change it po ha. Shakedown. Refer to shakedown. Klarong-klaro po yan. Other properties are deposited with the trust fund officer under recording and other receipts. Ano ibig sabihin ng contraband? Any article, item, or things prohibited by the law or forbidden by the jail or prison rules. For example, nagdala yung tao ng cellphone. Cellphone can be considered as a contraband. Why? It is not a violation of the law, but it is a violation of the prison rules. So therefore, classified siya na contraband. So, dapat i-confiscate po yan and then ibigay po sa property custodian. Rest assured na ang cellphone na yan will be returned when the person is about or is going to be released from prison. The last one would be the briefing and orientation. Okay, ano po ba ang briefing and orientation? So, sa briefing and orientation, the prisoner will be briefed and oriented on the rules and regulation of the prison before he will be assigned to the RDC or the quarantine unit. So, he will be lectured, he'll be acquainted with the rules and regulation po sa prison po natin. Okay? Now mga cadets, yun na po ang contents natin sa episode 3, pangatlong discussion po natin. Rest assured po na kung ano po ang kulang. Lahat ng remaining topics po natin sa subject na institutional correction shall be discussed on the last episode, yung episode 4 po. So I hope you will tune in. Thank you so much for your support, your appreciation, and your recognition on this channel. Again, ang ginagawa ko po is not for views or is not for subscribers. But then again, I am doing this to help those persons who cannot afford in registering or in enrolling in various review centers nationwide. Maraming salamat po. God bless you po, mga kadete.